In this lecture, we will look at some vignette filters and image borders in color effects. I have opened Word 1. At the left, I click on Vignette Filter. Transition is the distance between the inner and outer circle, as we saw in analog effects. With size, I adjust the size of the effect-free area. With opacity, I change the strength or opacity of the vignette. Behind shape, I can choose different shapes for the vignette. You can also adjust the color of the vignette. With the color picker, you can pick a color from your image. If you click on the color thumbnail, you can manually adjust the color. In the color square, from left to right is hue, and from top to bottom is saturation. At the right is the value slider, with which you can make a color lighter or darker. I click on OK. Adapt Edges looks at the image and tries to refine the shape for the vignette. I click on OK. For the second vignette filter, Vignette Lens, I have opened Bird 2. Vignette Lens simulates vignettes created by different types of lenses. I can transition the shape from more circular to more rectangular. I can adjust the size of the vignette. With Amount, I can make the vignette darker or lighter, and I can even invert the vignette. I can reposition the center of the vignette. I will increase the size to see this better. I click on the Place Center icon and click in the middle of the bird. I can also place a minus control point to exclude an area of the vignette. I click on the minus control point icon and click on the eye of the bird. And lastly, I can increase the brightness of the image a bit if it has become too dark. The next vignette is Vignette Blur. I have opened Portrait. With Vignette Blur, you defocus the detail around the center of the image, drawing the eye to the subject. There are 4 different blur types you can choose from. Type 4 blurs to white. I will make the transition a bit less soft and increase the size a bit. I click on the Place Center icon and click on her face to put the girl in the center of the vignette. In GIMP, I could crop the image again. Darken Lighten Center is a much more subtle way of vignetting. It gives depth to an image in a natural way. With Border Luminosity, I can darken or lighten the edges of the image. And with Center Luminosity, you determine the brightness of the center of the image. With Center Size, you make the border smaller or larger. Color Effects also has some adjustable image borders. I click on the Recipes tab, and at the bottom, I click on Vintage Saturation. I get a warning that adding this recipe will replace the filters at the right. I click on Yes. This recipe consists of 4 filters. First, the image has been given a bit more contrast. Then we have a lens vignette. Under it, we have an image border. And at the bottom, film grain. I zoom in to 200%. I can increase the size of the grain by dragging grain per pixel to the left. The grain makes the image look like it was shot with film. I press the spacebar to zoom out again. Now let's have a look at the image borders. There are several image borders to choose from. I can make an image border more rough or less rough. And with size, I can move the edge inwards or outwards. In the next lecture, we will look at how to make professional black and white images in Silver Effects Pro.